أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. In this structure we talked about the perfect building, the perfect chandelier. Every part of it is designed to complement the rest. And if we enlarge or decrease any part of it, it will mess up the whole structure. And this is what we mean by the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or we say it the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his saying, his action. And we Muslims, we know that the Quran and the Sunnah has been preserved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reached to us as is when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. And everything was perfect as he declared it on the Mount of Arafah, like 60-70 days before his death. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. So Islam is not the history of what happened after. Islam is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us by his saying and action, and the Quran which he uttered and was preserved all the way till now. So this balance is very important. Not talking about the haram, the unlawful, this is out. But the lawful, the daily thing and so on has to be conducted in moderation and without any extremism. Especially when it comes to ibadat. And this hadith illustrates that. عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال جاء ثلاثة رهط إلى بيوت أزواج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يسألون عن عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلما أخبروا كأنهم تقالوها وقالوا أين نحن من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر قال أحدهم أما أنا فأصلي الليل أبدا وقال الآخر وأنا أصوم الدهر أبدا ولا أفطر وقال الآخر أنا أعتزل النساء فلا أتزوج أبدا فجاء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إليهم فقال أنتم الذين قلتم كذا وكذا أما والله إني لأخشاكم لله وأتقاكم له لكني أصوم وأفطر وأصلي وأرقد وأتزوج النساء فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني. Narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. So the rough translation, the authority of Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه, he was a servant of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said that three group or three people came to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم homes, and they asked about the quality and quantity of his worship. And they were told what he does. But they found it little. And they say maybe because the Prophet is forgiven, so he doesn't have to pray or to fast or to do a lot. So, but we are going, one of them said, I will pray all night and never sleep. And the other one say, I'm going to fast every day for life. And the third one, he say, I'm going to live a life of celibacy and isolation. And so when the news came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came and he told, you say that? I swear by God that I know God and fear God more than anyone else. But I fast and I break fast. I pray at night and I sleep and I marry wives. And anyone who does not do my way, he is not one of me. Anyone who does not do my sunnah, my way, my method, my example, my what I taught in saying and action, he's not one of me. In other words, that means he's not a Muslim. So, or he's not a perfect Muslim. So this leads us to the subject of al-ghulu. As in that picture of Popeye, he had a very swollen arms, forearms from eating too much Spanish. But his body is very slim and his muscles are weak, the rest of his body. So we should be very careful to train ourselves proportionally, all groups of muscle, the same thing, all aspects of Islam. From ibadat to mu'amalat to moral values, everything. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us that to avoid extremism, you find people focusing on dhikr or focusing on some aspects of ibadat, like making umrah 100 times, 200 times. And you find him cheating and lying and doing everything bad in society, in his dealing and wheeling. So you find others exaggerating many aspects of Islam. I don't want to go into details. So we have to be very careful to be balanced. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O people, ya ayyuhan nas, iyyakum wal ghulu. Iyyakum wal ghulu fi al-deen. فَإِنَّهُ أَهْلَكَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ الْغُلُو فِي الدِّينِ. So, to be extremist is destructive. And the yester generations or nations or civilizations were destroyed by extremism. In another hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about those who do things not according to his sunnah, to his way, to the proportions he has done it, the quality and the quantity he has done it. And this is what we call tanattu'. He said, halaka al-mutanatti'un. Halaka al-mutanatti'un. Halaka al-mutanatti'un. Narrated by Imam Muslim. أي التشدد في الأمور الدينية والدنيوية. So the extremism is not good. And remember the old wisdom that the virtue is a middle point between two vices. So starvation is a vice. Indulgence and gluttony is a vice. Overweight and all of this. The middle ground, لُقَيْمَاتٍ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبَةٍ, to eat very mildly or one third of your stomach, فَثُلُثٌ لِطَعَامِهِ. This is, the whole Islam as well is this middle ground, this the virtue thing in every aspect of Islam. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.